All right, I'm calling this meeting to order, this meeting March 6th of the Reuse Subcommittee of the Board of Public Works. We were not able to approve the January minutes at the last meeting, so have people read the January and February minutes?
Yes.
There are copies in the middle of the table. They're needed to remove.
Has everyone here read the minutes? Peter, did you read the minutes from January, February?
No.
Okay, well, why don't we give you a few minutes to go through that?
The January minutes, Ginny's name misspelled, as Jessica pointed out to me.
That was my fault.
I think at least twice, because I had hoped to get them fixed before I sent them out.
Ginny is in G-I-N-N-Y?
No.
Is it I-E? What is the...
G-I-N-N-I-E, and then I had the last name spelled wrong. I kind of threw it in, and I was going to look it up, and I forgot to look it up.
I guess spelled it away.
If we're going to be that picky, my name is actually J-O-N.
Ah, okay.
But I've long ago given up worrying about that.
Okay.
Is that because your name is Jonathan?
And Ginny's last name is spelled what, Jessica?
I think it's D-U-R-Y-E-E.
Yeah, that sounds good.
Okay. I was just checking.
While Peter's reading the minutes, does anyone have any changes other than misspellings to revise the minutes?
They look good. Very well done.
Yes, thank you, Jessica.
Jessica, phenomenal. Nothing pops out.
I guess the one thing that pops out for me, just because I try to take these things seriously, is under goal, it says Susan Waite actions, and the implication is that I'm going to be doing all these things.
All the what?
And it scared the bejeebies out of me. It says Susan Waite actions. So, I mean, some of them I was going to do, but reaching out to Massachusetts Reuse Centers to find out how they're run, developing a set of rules regarding volunteers, customers, and what material. I mean, these were actions that the group needs to take.
That's right.
But not necessarily.
Yeah. We talked about dividing up the
right.
Reuse centers.
So somehow, maybe delete my name there, Susan Waite, or
how about
something?
Group action?
Group actions,
know,
does that work?
I don't know what you suggest, but I just want to be a little off.
Okay, group actions.
Group action.
Group action.
Any other changes?
Yeah.
Revisions? Do I have a motion to pass the minutes with those revisions?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All right. The Reuse Resource Working Group.
No, we have February minutes.
We have February minutes.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was doing both at the same time.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, was everyone doing both? Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm sorry.
So both are passed.
Okay.
Reuse Resource Working Group report.
Yes, I'd be happy to do that, and Peter can chime in, and Diana if need be.
Debbie's not here.
She's trying to find a parking space. She said that they were.
So there's been a slight delay in calling other organizations, and that's my fault, so I take ownership of that, and I'm going to get stuff out to people today. But essentially, there's stuff that can be moving forward, and it doesn't, you know, it's not linear, and so there's a lot of different things that can be getting done as we move forward, because our original goal was to have something that was presentable to the Board of Public Works by April 1st. So MAC has gotten started on a project plan, kind of a business plan type thing that I'm going to work on a little bit more while he's gone, and present to the committee. So one of the things that we might want to consider is having another meeting before or very early in April, or before April 1st, so that we can have something that we can present to the entire committee for the committee's approval before it goes to the board. We can talk about that a little bit more, but I just, because Ro and David were having a conversation that I think would be good for the group to have input on. But the kinds of things that can be going on while, between now and April, and we're looking for help if anyone has ideas or connections or resources that they can offer, these were the kinds of things that, that need to be discussed and need to be finished. We some kind of a project management thing that I can probably help out with organizing this and making sure that these things are going on so that we can reach a point where everything is, or most things are done, most of the key things are done. A renovation plan, we have a list of things that we wanted to have done. I think I distributed it via email. It's not an outrageous list. There, we might have to winnow it down a little bit more, hopefully not. But how are those things gonna get done? What is the timing that's gonna happen? Have we, what kind of turnaround time from asking the city electrician to put in some lighting in, inside to when it actually gets happened, when it actually would happen. I don't know what his work schedule is like, but you know, kind of thinking about those things and making sure that those things are moving along. Publicity, Debbie has was working on a letter where she was gonna announce this. Diana has asked, you know, when are, what are we going to put out there on Facebook and to our email, you know, so working out a plan for at notifying people and rolling this out. Advisory board, we talked last time we met about who the advisory board should be. Should it be us? Should it be us and a subset of other people? Should it be a subset of us and some other people? That needs to be decided, and I hope we can maybe talk a little bit about it today. Revolving fund, Debbie is going to look into that a little bit. Ned had suggested that we talk to Patty Shaughnessy from the Senior Center because she has a number of revolving funds, and that is the only way that I'm that Ned is aware of that we would be able to accept money from the public for use for advertising and other things.
I checked with Joyce Karpinski, who's the assistant to the treasurer, she's the auditor or whatever, because I wanted to make sure, as you had suggested, that sending checks to Green Northampton is, you know, doable. So she actually had to look into that.
Uh-huh.
The revolving fund is a state thing, and it's much more, she says, it's much more complex. And I don't know if they already have revolving funds at
right.
Senior Center.
And, I, and maybe it's called something different.
Yeah.
Maybe that, that's not, that's maybe that's what the DPW calls it, but that in her eyes is something else. I don't know. We'll have
well,
to
anyway,
make sure.
It's much more formal. You have to go through state application, et cetera.
Mm-hmm.
And, so, you know, that's much more complex than would be needed. But anyway, just
Okay. We also, at some point, need to come up with a name. It would be helpful to do that sooner rather than later, so we can start referring to it in publicity and stuff like that. I'm just going through the list, and then we can talk about it. Volunteers, we want to make sure we have a volunteer database and start thinking about what kind of training and job aids are going to be available. Mac and I had spoken at one point, and it's not that a big training session or, you know, week-long training session is necessary, but when there is some training that will be necessary, and what will be most effective, perhaps, is having some really effective job aids that, you know, like, just little, like, you know, posters on the wall saying, you know, blah, 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 you know, have you done this, this, and this, and so that's fairly easy to do, but you have to kind of figure out what they need to know, and that needs some time. And then collecting materials. We know we need shelving units. We know we need some bins and stuff like that. So these are all things that are ongoing. If any of you have passion around any of those, let me know. And if you can't make it to the meetings that we've been having on Tuesday mornings, then we'll figure something out. And Peter, did you have something to say about the name?
Yes. I spent yesterday on, I don't know how many hours, really making up a nice thing. I wanted to envision an actual center. And to do that, the only way I could do it was actually to see the road sign out on Glendale Road. And unfortunately, I left the thing at home, but best practices, and I'm looking around at acronyms like SCRAP and all this, but for what I think we have the possibility of doing here, I'm going to have to just do it quickly, is 140 Glendale Road, Northampton Resource Recovery Center for Recreativity. It's not trash till you throw it away. And that's how I saw the road sign out there.
That's cute. I like that.
That's not my own, you know, just gather.
Yeah.
But Resource Center for short, I mean, you know, shortened basically. And maybe the re-center, because I'd like to also submit an addenda of re, all the re, I mean, beyond reduce, reuse, recycle. I mean, I'm added 100, I think, that are all relevant. In fact, any verb can practically have re put in front of it, except be. That's the only one. To be or not to be, to re-be? That one I couldn't work, but that's how I see
it.
It's
fun. I would suggest having a, maybe we could have a breakfast meeting or a dinner meeting or some kind of outside meeting to talk about a couple of things and hash some of these things out, and people could bring their ideas and we can figure out what we think has the most, you know, oomph and potential. And I love that you're thinking about it, and I love that you're, I mean, I'm a visual person too, so I think of the sign up.
Well, resource centers in, is, yeah, can we turn
I'm
it
gonna,
off?
I'm going with that.
Is it
I'm going to try this.
Yeah, that should work.
Or not.
Oh, it might not. It might be.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah.
Okay. Good job. Looking at reuse, you know, it's very commonly used, and this has been used for 10, 12 years to come up with this thing. So this is not that. This is new. This is the resource center, and that's going to happen. So, because we have the space. Because we talked a little bit, well, does everybody know what a resource center is? Well, resource recovery is very understandable. And for recreativity, which is my hope for us, that this be educational, this be using resources, in effect, to develop entrepreneurship.
Do we want to decide this right now?
No. We're going to need
a
meeting to deal with things like naming. So,
one thing that I would like to get discussed a little bit more right now is the advisory board situation. We talked last week that I think David said, "Why can't we just be the advisory board?" And my opinion is that we have only an hour a month to meet. So if this group was to be the advisory board, we would have to meet outside of this. And I would also think, I also think it's important to have some other people represented from other industries, whether it's construction, real estate, you know,
accounting.
A hauler, accounting, you know, whatever. Mm-hmm. So there could potentially be some other people on the advisory board that would be beneficial. So that's my opinion, and I guess I want to turn it over and find out what you guys think.
I think everybody should be included here because we've all been here so long, and if anybody got slighted, that would be wrong to me. But I think including more people who have different outside experiences would be valuable as well. Mm-hmm. But then how big does it get?
Well, that's a good question. You know, how big do you want a board to be? You know, there aren't any real, I've seen boards of 26 or 30, and yeah. I've seen boards of 3, so.
Mm-hmm. What if we asked people if they wanted to be on the board? Because we're assuming that everyone would be interested in being on it. I mean, this is also related, actually, to the developing plan for mission and objectives. And David, I was going to ask if maybe we could switch these two in the agenda.
Okay.
Because we need to think about what the, as I'm doing research trying to figure out when this group was formed and exactly what its charge was, it's clear that, well, in talking to Ned, he said, well, if there isn't anything written, and there is a couple things that I found, maybe the committee should figure out what they think they could do. So I have found a mission statement that's around creating a reuse center and promoting reuse. If this is the best thing that we have, then that's this committee's, I'm losing track of what I'm trying to say.
This committee's purpose?
Yeah, I guess, I mean, this committee's purpose, from what I understand, is to promote reuse. So in that respect, having this committee as a key part of the board, of a governing board of a reuse center makes total sense. When we start talking about other things like getting involved in band projects or other stuff that may or may not have to do with reuse and may or may not have to do specifically with a reuse center, that's when it would help to have clarification of what our goals are. Do we want to expand the goals, or do we want to think about maybe it's appropriate for a different group to form that would deal with other waste reduction issues? Some of, you know, on which some of you guys could serve. But you don't, when you have groups, unless there's a clear reason for them to be going on, you know, it's not necessarily healthy or right for them to be going on ad nauseum. So it would help for us to understand what we're here for, agree on that, and then when we've achieved that, you know, figure out what the next step is. And we certainly have, it would be appropriate, I think, for us to make recommendations about where we think other things could.
Susan, what you're suggesting is that there was no mission or objectives handed down to us by the BPW when this committee was, it wasn't actually formed, but it was
evolved,
redirected from what it was originally. So
I have not found a whole lot, but I have found, some documents in Karen's files. So one of them actually says Northampton Reuse Committee Mission Statement. I made copies of it here, and I found a couple of other things as well. I don't know if that's... It says, in cooperation with Northampton's administration and Department of Public Works, the Reuse Committee will establish a permanent, visible reuse center and or resource recovery park in the city, operated under the guiding principles of zero waste. The committee will strive to make this facility convenient, properly scaled, and financially self-sustaining. The committee will create volunteer-run programs to increase awareness of existing opportunities for reuse in Pine River Valley and will form partnerships with local reuse organizations to promote their growth and success. The committee will also identify unmet needs for reuse, investigate how to bridge the gaps, and develop new options for reuse for residents and small businesses in Northampton. This was a document that was, this dated January 2012.
Yes, but this was related to Karen putting together a zero waste proposal using state funds that she was also hiring
Harlene.
Thank you, Harlene, to help with. The reuse committee was actually established even before the citywide solid waste committee that David and I served on, because it was a commitment from the board to reuse. And so I would check the BP, I know this is my work, but I'm just saying that this goes back to I think I sent you stuff as early as fall of 2008.
If you look in that, so I also, if you guys remember, I mentioned at the last meeting that I had put together pieces of things that I had found for historical background. This is, I made three copies. I mean, it's
Of what, Susan?
This is just it's collections of all the stuff that I could find about the history of the reuse center. So it's
well, the whole purpose of this is to have a mission
right.
and objectives for the reuse committee. So my suggestion, since it's difficult to mine this stuff and reconstruct the chronology of it all, is that there should be a few people as a subcommittee here to come up with a mission and objectives for the reuse committee that can be brought back to this group, agreed upon, and then proposed to the Board of Public Works. That would be my suggestion.
And I have, Ro, I spent 2 hours Tuesday looking through Board of Public Works minutes, and I, it's I'm happy to share with you what I have. I made copies of a lot of stuff. There has been talk about it for a long time, but I was unable to find something that said, this is their charge. And maybe I didn't go back far enough, so you and I should probably talk offline. But I have looked, and you know, there's a point at which, like David said, there's a point at which, how much time should I be spending on doing this to try to dig up what had happened years ago?
You know, I guess I tend to agree with David that we had the strongest committee we've had in a long time, I think. And you and I have discussed about this. I hate to see you keep going through this, because over time missions can change, and the idea that we do have a drafting of what we're doing here, as long as it incorporates reuse and with an allusion, or however we decide, to a reuse center, and we just get a current board support, I think that would be all we would need, just to clarify what we're doing and what our energy is. I hate to see you keep going. Yeah, I know you're trying to do the right
point,
thing.
There's a point at which they're diminishing returns, mm-hmm. I guess. Mm-hmm.
Right, exactly. Right. And you have a lot in your head from this as well, but was that what you were trying to say? What I just said?
Yes.
Okay.
As far as your proposal.
Yes. And so I'm comfortable with that.
Okay.
And then just to, and that would be the first, just to have current endorsement and support from the board, which we're wanting to clarify issues anyway. Wanting to clarify, I think it's public knowledge, and I was saying to people before this show that the Solid Waste Fund, which supports reuse, reuse center, our community, is losing money. And this is a serious, it's projected to lose $60,000 this year $100,000 next year. And that's, it's not sustainable, and this is a serious issue. And even though the board nominally is totally supportive of reuse and the reuse center, that's never been in doubt, whether or not there's a formal statement there. The issue is that we have to make sure our enterprise funds are solvent. And so we're wrestling with a lot of different ways right now. Ned has already talked to the mayor once. He plans to talk to the mayor again. We're wrestling with Susan's position because it's an important position, and you in particular have made it more valuable than it's been for a while. And I don't think I'm speaking out of turn on saying that. And I just think that I don't want the momentum that this group has done so far to be stopped, because it's the best it's been in a long time. And the two of you have been here for a while. We've done a lot of good things. You've got all the events going. This is part of the structure. We now have a governance structure. This is a progress. We have a proposed site for a reuse center. I think we've made some huge progress. And so we need to simultaneously clarify our use, but also keep going in the direction we're going.
Can I relay your fear somewhat? Because I just don't see it as a problem. Because with a different structure, like Green Northampton or No Waste Coalition, we can attract funds from elsewhere. The big problem right now is having to go, go through all these permissions for stuff all the time. You know, rather than sort of take it more as a social entrepreneurship enterprise that we're doing here, which is a new code, municipal company, cooperative, whatever combination. And so just getting this financing part out of it under your jurisdiction, frankly, would be much more helpful than having to worry about if there's enough money in this fund or that fund.
So, hey, Peter, let me make a proposal, and that is that we create a working group of three people to come up with a mission and objectives for the reuse committee, subcommittee, that can be brought back to this group edited, approved, and then proposed to the Board of Public Works.
Somebody, is that a motion?
That is a motion.
I'm second. I think that's excellent.
Is there anyone that would like to work on that group? I would like to work on that group.
I would like to work on that group.
So Susan, Peter, Diana, and me.
Could we have a date? I mean, do you think maybe by the next?
We would like to do it by the next meeting, yes.
Okay, cool. And with something to go out in the, in email to all of us before the next meeting for us to consider?
We can try, depending upon what we can meet.
Yes, I understand.
Yeah.
But I mean, I think that would be really fabulous. How are you feel about that?
Other than feeling my blood pressure going up with every new commitment that I make. No, I mean, it's all good, and I'm excited about this. And yes, I feel like I should be involved because I've done some mole work, you know? And so, yeah, no, I'm fine with it. I just need to do some deep reading.
Susan, be comfortable. This will go forward. If you have other commitments that take you away, then that's fine. Diana, Peter, and I will get the job done.
Well, I can share what I have with you guys, and you can take it from there. I did want to say that something that I have noticed, Ro very nicely said that things have changed, and you like some of the change, and I just wanted to say that I have noticed that one thing that I've been doing that Karen was not able to do or hadn't done is focus a lot on this group. I have spent a lot of my time and a lot of my hours doing stuff supporting this group, and Karen did a lot of great stuff with grants and grant funding, and that takes a lot of time and innovation, and coming in new to the situation, I don't have the bandwidth or understanding to be able to be innovative and write grants and stuff like that. So that I just want to say that that's a piece that could happen that I'm not dealing with. That
she was full time
for this position.
She
was full time. Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And that's in part of the conflict, is that one source of reducing, making the fund solvent is to reduce this position to part time, and most of us, including Ned, aren't happy about that. And that's why in email I sent to many of you in response to another one, it's the mayor that we're having to lobby and
convince. Yes. Well,
he has a lot on his plate, and there's other things out there, but I don't think the board or the department is our nemesis.
Mm-hmm. I just have a quick question. Do you have, Ro, can you speak to the Board of Public Works, just the structured process thing? Can we bring you our mission, and that will work, like the board
yes,
will work?
Yes, okay. Yes, yes.
Because in the past, I felt like the board was giving us the mission, and it was going that way, and I wasn't sure if it was going to fly for us to propose our
own
mission.
It can go either way, but the board has other things to focus on,
right.
So
okay.
It will happen faster if we do it this way.
Right. Mm-hmm.
I don't have a problem with that at all. Yeah, I think that what you're proposing is ingenuity, and I think responsibilities are an iterative process in an open forum, which we are trying. You know, the whole city tries to have this more civic concept.
Yeah, so I just wanted to make sure the door swung that way.
I don't think it's a problem. I mean, I think it's a budgetary conflict, but not a philosophical one.
So the reason why I pulled all this stuff into that is that when we're talking about the advisory board, you know, it's not crystal clear what the mission of this group is. So for, you know, is it, you know, should this group be the advisory board based on what I can understand this group has formed or had evolved to? I think so, but that also is going to color, you know, potentially what the final mission also kind of colors the advisory board. But we, at the same time, we can't wait for too long. So
by advisory board, do you mean a broader group that ensures community collaboration?
So yeah, and we talked about this a little bit at our last meeting. There's two different needs. There's like a management team that's going to be managing the day-to-day stuff, and then there's an advisory board that helps remove obstacles and brings in other resources and knowledge to help solve issues and problems. So I see kind of two, you know, there's like a management group, and then there's an advisory board. So maybe that clarification needs to be made, and this group needs to be heavily involved in the management, and some of this group be on an advisory board with people like from the Board of Public Works, maybe an engineer from the department, and then some of the other industry groups' representation, like we talked about a little earlier.
Do we need a committee to make a list of who, what kind of input we need on the advisory board?
We have some stuff already.
But isn't there's the group that's meeting already about the
Reeves
Center?
About
so
it.
That's I think that working group exists.
Okay.
It is that the advisory board should be part of what the discussion is.
So how about if the working group that is meeting on Tuesdays come up with a plan for managing versus advising, and have that be part of what's proposed and discussed when we approve whatever is approved before it goes to the Board of Public Works. Does that make sense? The working group that's working on the Reeves Center propose a management and advisory structure, and that gets proposed along with everything else when we meet as a group to approve whatever goes to the board. Did I do better that time?
Mm-hmm. Sure.
Diana,
can you say it in a different way?
I think that there's already a subcommittee from this group that's working on the Reeves Center specifically, and we can hash out what the difference is between the management group of the Reeves Center and the advisory board of the Reeves Center, and we'll clarify what those two groups are doing, and it'll be part of what's proposed to the Board of Public Works when we propose the whole plan for the Reeves Center.
But it will first be approved by this group.
Right, well, the whole thing will be approved by this group before it goes to the Board of Public Works.
Will we need an advisory group to advise the advisory board?
Yes.
Probably.
Yes, at least two. That's the Board of Public Works.
Right. Well, I mean, it's similar in structure to what you have with the board, what you're proposing to the board. I mean, you know, the management is the department.
It's somewhat similar in structure. I tell you why I feel strongly about this. With composting in schools, it's something that we've struggled with in Amherst, and I've seen a lot of my colleagues deal with in a whole bunch of other communities. And the communities where it works the best is where you have some kind of an advisory board with people who know the industry and have the power, positional power, to make things happen. These are people who aren't going to want to come and be at a monthly meeting talking about schedules and volunteer schedules and stuff like that. These are people who want to be there. They want to support it. They want to remove obstacles to make things happen. And the schools that struggle, from the understanding and research that I've done, are the ones that don't have that. So I don't want this group to struggle. I don't want this group to be have a bunch of managers and not some people who are clearing the way for the future.
So that's
what I mean by an advisory board.
Is there anything else that the working group wants to report to this group at this point?
About the resource center.
I have one thing. We talked a little bit about, as part of the business plan for the reuse center, including the skills that this group brings to it, the people who are already working on, have been working on this for a while. So if you have a little two-sentence bio you could email to me, that would be helpful.
And try to focus on the skills that are important for the reuse center.
Yeah.
I know you guys all have some amazing backgrounds, but we want to keep it relatively short and present it to the board, so focus on what you're bringing to this.
So everyone project. Should send you a two-sentence email.
I would love that.
Okay.
Yeah. If you don't, we'll work around it.
So the other part that I'd like to bring up on to the resource center involves Smith Volk, and I did mention it last time. I'm going to meet with John Kelly in a little bit. So one of the focuses would be, for instance, collecting lamps that are broken or lamp for lamp parts, etc., and getting a lamp program, a repair program going there. I talked again to Scott Sabin yesterday, who I will meet with tomorrow, and work out how a presentation would be done to the faculty there and how we get this going so that we already start with something ahead of the opening of the center. So
well, can I I have to say that I am and I am a little compromised because I'm under pressure in a number of ways, but I see the repair thing, this is just my opinion, I see the repair thing as being this really fabulous concept, but there's so much to do right now to get this baby off the ground. I would request that, is it possible that you channel some of that amazing tenacity and energy and creativity into some of these things and making these things happen?
I just don't see them as mutually exclusive. It's a very simple.
No, it's not. Yeah. I know, but we have limited resources, so it would be great. I'm just making a request. Right. You can deny the request, well, but if you could channel some of that into some of these things, that would be. It would make me very happy.
Yeah, I will channel as much as possible. This to me is important, and after Diana mentioned, you know, household should be as important as art stuff. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I saw lamps as the single most best thing to keep out of the waste, keep out of the waste stream, because parts, as an electrician once told me. So, and that would get a program going over there that would get them involved with the resource center. Mm-hmm. And I think that connection, from an educational standpoint, for hands-on folks.
It's a great idea.
And I'd like them to be right there from the beginning, because I think that's another selling point. You know, if I'm going to do publicity for this, mm-hmm. I want a selling point to be like Scrap. It's an educational function. Mm-hmm. It's to promote resourcefulness, in one word. Mm-hmm. That's it, to promote resourcefulness. And I think that's a really good connection to have.
I agree, and I applaud your efforts, Peter. Is there anything else from the working group? Because we should get to the rest of the agenda. Okay, so until the next meeting, that's it for the working group report. Event coordinator updates. So what this means is every reuse recycling event we're doing starting in April has a coordinator, and what we would like to see is a report from the next three or four events from each coordinator at each of these meetings, so that everyone understands exactly what the development is. So the first event is that yours, Peter, the first event?
Well, it's 26.
The
26th.
26th,
yeah,
is
John.
The spelling
bee.
It was the 12th pellets.
So April 12th is the first one.
Yeah. Before we get into specifics, did you guys see the... can I get some feedback on the form that I sent out?
Looks great.
Yep.
I thought it looked great.
Did anyone, was it missing anything?
A lot there.
There is a lot there.
This is.
I'm not sure all of it applied. You know, I mean, I was looking over it. In fact, I had a long conversation with Karen on a Sunday because I wanted to catch up with her on how stuff had gone before. I don't know if you need to get into all of this, but I asked her what was the biggest problem. It was the no-shows, mm-hmm. people who just didn't show
the
up.
The tech sale.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, registered, didn't show up.
And $10 wasn't enough so that they would show up. Well, right. That's why I went to the $25 commitment, but then giving it back, which is, I think, cumbersome. So a registration fee of some sort, regardless. And if
Wait, Peter, before we get into that, are there comments specifically about this form so that Susan can
revise it
according to our needs?
No,
I thought it looked great.
Really good.
Okay.
Just about everything went.
Okay.
So is John going to report on the 0 week?
I can.
Or on the spelling meeting?
Well, the first event is the 12th.
Yes.
Which is that right?
Well, March 26th.
Oh, March 26th. Yeah. Oh, okay, John, sorry. Yeah.
That's okay. So it turns out JFK is not composting its food. I was under the impression by the science teacher who told me they were. They're not. So I have to talk with you, because I talked to the DPW about getting bins at JFK for that event.
Mm-hmm.
The woman who's at the desk, I don't know her name.
Deb.
Said it shouldn't be a problem, but I should talk with you about it. Uh-huh. So I'll do
if,
that.
If you need bio bags.
Talk to you.
So Green North Hampton will fund the bio bags. We get them from Alternative Recycling.
Yeah.
From Patrick Kennedy.
Yeah, they charge per bin, I guess, to pick up. I'm told $11 a bin.
Alternative Recycling?
Yeah.
Oh, they used to do it for free. I didn't realize
yeah,
that
they're charging. I believe
we can talk. We have a meeting afterwards.
Yeah. So okay. I'll catch up for that. But otherwise, I mean, there's nothing else to say about that. I did check with the high school because they're starting composting Monday. It's not part of our event, but talking about the schools becoming more.
And who is, recycling. You know, who's leading the composting?
Yeah, Ellen Hirschberg's the nurse there, who's the adult, but really she said the kids are driving it. And I heard what you said about having an advisory group. I'm going to meet with them this afternoon, actually, the environmental club.
So it's Northampton High School?
Or Northampton High School.
And who's the head of the environmental club now?
Anna Moore is one of the three young women that are running it. And they're going to start Monday doing composting. So
and
I'm
where
talk
would
with
the
them.
Compost go?
What's that?
Where would the compost go?
The city will take it. Our alternative
recycling.
Recycling will take it. They have two
the
bins.
Composting in the city.
Okay.
They have two bins at $11 a bin. So that's we'll see how that goes.
So what is that $11 a month? Or
$11? Well, they're thinking
each bin is
costs
$11.
Every time they pick it up. Every time they pick it up, it's $11. That's what that's what they're doing. So
wow. I mean, yeah. We used to generate one tote every day at Jackson Street School.
Yeah, that's a concern about where the money's going to come from. Right.
Part my experience is the high school kids' compost tends to be less food and more paper waste.
Mm-hmm.
The elementary school kids, they don't get to pick what they eat.
Right.
They're fussier.
Yeah, true.
They get the same amount of food whether they want it or not. So there tends to be more food in elementary school compost.
But there's a concern about that. Anyway, I'll meet with them, but that's separate. But I think we're on track. The 26th, JFK knows about it, but we'll have to talk about getting the bins there. And the city, Deb, said that she would work out a way to get there. So we're set.
Okay.
And you and Matt said you'd be there.
I will be.
Okay.
The April event is pellet bags, foam, textiles, medical durables, and shredding. I have a couple calls into the shredding people. They have not returned my call. So today, after the meeting, I'm going to keep calling, essentially, until I get someone. So I'm a little worried about that because spring is a busy time for them. So, but they have not returned my calls in the past two and were able to show. So I have my fingers crossed. I don't have a whole lot to report. Most of this stuff we can do ourselves. I do need to get in touch with people about the medical durables. Do you guys know what happened in the past with medical durables? Stavros Center with the... Okay. That's it for April.
There's also the Hilltown... Elder Center, I think, in Chesterfield is starting a new sharing program with medical durables.
Okay, it's the Hilltown what?
Elder Center, maybe?
Okay.
Senior Center? It's in the center of Chesterfield, and I brought them some stuff recently.
Okay.
It's a newspaper ad.
Uh-huh.
Peter, you have an event on the 26th?
Right. So, basically, you'd want to volunteer, how many volunteers?
and when you'll need them.
Yeah. So basically six. Diana, if you would be able to, I mean, they don't have to be for the whole time. You did the signs always, signage for the tax sale?
It's not the case, but there is signage.
I did the signage.
Yeah.
And actually, if I can just interject, I had an idea because last year, each time before, I either had the engineering department make signs or I had created the signs.
and they weren't weatherproof, and they were paper, and so each time we had to make new signs. So I came up with a plan for some regular signs to be made, and at the time Ned said that they could probably cover it if it was within reason. So I was thinking of the corrugated plastic signs, like the political signs, and we could try to get the bigger size. But things, so I worked out a plan where we could get some that say reuse event today kind of stuff, and so that some are generic, so that all we would have to worry about is some specific wording signs. So because creating the signs each time, frankly, was very stressful. So.
Push.
Yeah, well, but you wouldn't even have to push them into the ground. I mean, we'd have the stakes, but you could also, you know, tape them to things. You could, you know, there are different ways you could use them. So I'm hoping to get that worked through, and I just wanted to put that out there because it should relieve the sign pressure.
My only question is whether that reuse event means anything to the general public.
Well, it was, I mean, that wasn't specific. The wording was more like, you know, some of them said today, some of them said reuse event here. Yeah, I mean, exit signs, you know, things like that, so we don't have to think about those, and then we can just think about a big sign that says tag sale or,
I see.
You know.
Okay.
Yeah, I think we would do promotion for whatever the event is, but then once it would be in a reminder, I think that's a useful reminder to have permanent signs that we can use for a variety, just generic enough that they would be reused.
Okay.
And if they're easy to set out, as opposed to, you know, you can use something that has a weighted base.
Right.
That with the sign that goes in it, because that takes care of wind and all that. Mm-hmm. It shouldn't be too hard to do. And again, the Smith boat might be, by the way, help.
So we've decided that Susan's form is really helpful and thorough. So I think it would be good for each coordinator talking about your event to go through each of these categories and talk about what your progress is. So, for instance, the venue is at
Smith Vocational.
In
the parking lot.
Are there
with the indoors needed because the bathrooms, which requires three, it's $100, which I guess DPW pays.
They have paid in the past. I also wanted to say I have reserved the venues for all the dates that we have on our thing.
Okay.
So Smith, the only date that is not reserved right now is December, because we're not sure with the ski swap and sale. Mm-hmm. So everyone, but regardless, the event coordinators, it would be helpful for you just to check in with me, because I might have more information for you on your specific event.
So the costs, that's one of the costs. And here again, if this were perhaps rebranded as a Green Northampton event, then maybe that cost wouldn't even fall under the DPW and we start getting
correct.
Out of the the railroad tracks. And partners, environmental clubs, then there were students from Smith College, the Salvation Army, and Shredders. I don't know quite where the students from Smith College, which they were, but that and any others. Yeah, students from
they have
college.
Come in the past.
And there's an environmental program and center at Smith.
Well, that, you know, I mean, the more the merrier as far as I'm concerned.
Right.
So.
But I wouldn't count on them, but they have shown up in the past.
Volunteers. Six, if you would be...
Just email me, Peter, and then I will go out and get them.
Yeah. Well, if you can do traffic, that was kind of that was an important one, because you did a good job on that. And if Jess can do pictures, maybe for the NCTV
publicity photographs.
Yeah, can we put up on NCTV last year's tag sale, other years that have already been done, and we'll play it as we get to it.
Yeah,
and then saying this year's event on the date that it is 26. During Karen says it was one of the easiest of all our events to do. Actually, didn't take, but she thought she and Deb could do it. Oh yeah, Deb would be paid, or Deb was very useful.
I'm sure she's paid.
She's paid.
If she could be that day paid, Was it 3 hours?
Yeah, we'll have to check into that, I think.
Yeah, because she was invaluable. Printing. I don't really have any other costs at the moment. I don't see much there. Safety cones and vests, first aid kits, coordinated, goes around and checks in. Well, this is all just management stuff. So publicity advertising, we do Facebook, and hopefully can get somebody from the art community who's good at this stuff, design, et cetera, as quickly as possible, so that we can really start getting out through social media as much, which doesn't cost us anything.
Right.
And the email list from that Deb has from last year is about 50 long, 50 people long, and I think you had integrated that? Yeah.
So how about Hampshire Life, Peter, and the Gazette?
Dan D. McConnell sent him stuff, and we had that previous last year, too. The same thing. It was in 3 times total.
Right.
Never had any luck with the advocate. Just hopeless, as far as I'm concerned. And that to be expanded some, as, you know, mostly publicity. I really think publicity is best bang for the buck, because there's no buck, just time. Signage, that's good if you've got that organized. Supplies and equipment was the coffee, the coffee cups, which you had found.
I don't know about coffee cups. Yeah. There's tea and cocoa and stuff like that.
Right. Well, that may be. But getting the environmental club to do that, I didn't know who to contact.
It would probably be Anna Moore, or there are other clubs. We can talk offline.
Yeah.
There are some other clubs, too.
The collect deposit, who will do it? Will be, I think that's
so
Saturday cleanup.
Who does do that, Peter? Who collects the registration fees?
Well, that would be, as I currently hope, will be okay with the city. We'll go to, do you have them?
It's fine with me.
Well, but we don't know if it's okay with the city, so we need to confirm that.
Well, I'm waiting for her to call me back.
Okay. Okay.
She was going to discuss
it. So in that case, Peter, all I have to do is write checks to Green North Hampton. If it works out.
Yeah, is there a
That's that simple.
Is there a PO box or something?
My home address.
Yeah. Okay, so that, again, that gets more out of the DPW event, and I tell people it's a reuse committee event. You know, in fact, I don't want to involve the DPW in obligation as much as possible in all our events. Really, you know, I mean, they've got roads to fix and things. So I see what we're doing is a different, it's an entrepreneurial, social entrepreneurial, whatever you call it, activity. So set up and clean up was the only other.
But I have to call you on that.
Yes.
And that I totally love the thought, but it is totally under the aegis of the DPW, and so we are responsible for any legal or different issues.
The event
that come
over
up.
The apps, man. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Oh, absolutely.
Anything. Yes. Because if it's under the reuse committee, because it's part of the DPW. Just getting a framework.
It's also,
yeah.
I think your concept is good, but I'm just saying liability.
I mean, just reserving over there, they're not charging us because we are a city organization that's making the register. So we are under the auspices of the DPW.
So that's not an actual expense, the $100?
No, that's an additional expense. If you're
personnel.
Yeah, if you are not a city business and you want to use the Smith Folk facilities, there's a fee to use the facility, which is waived if you're a city organization. So,
does it cost the DPW $100 to do that or not?
Yes,
we have to pay
for
custodial. Yeah.
Right. Okay.
It would cost you as a person more than that.
Including the rent would
that's,
be,
that's
yes.
Right.
Right. Right. So that's the only thing, we've got to have brooms in case there's no litter, no trash, nothing. So the cleanup would be helpful to have in as many there who can do that. I'll be a participant and maybe be where the cars come through or something, but I can, you know, still be like where the people come in first.
Mm-hmm.
I'll figure that out. So. Mm-hmm. Roger, I talked to him a month ago now, I think, and he hasn't come to the last two meetings, so, but he would be a volunteer, I would hope.
Okay, so, Peter, just send me an email with 6 volunteers, times that you need them, and then we'll take care of getting them. What's the next event after that?
The next event is,
May 3rd.
Our Kids Stuff Exchange.
And the bulky rigid plastic.
And bulky rigid plastic.
Oh, that's before the SOS?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Yes, the week before.
May 3rd.
All right, and Susan, are you the coordinator of that one?
No, actually Diana and Josh.
And we're meeting with Susan right after this, so we have nothing to report.
Okay.
Agreed.
But we'll have something to report in 2 hours.
Okay.
Or an hour.
But you'll send me a list of coordinators, of volunteers that you need for the event.
Yep. I have a general question. Do we have a list that we're comfortable promoting right now, advertising that these are our events that are coming up?
Yes.
We're settled on all that?
Well, the only thing is we can't advertise shredding if we don't have a shredder.
That's what I'm wondering about,
yeah,
that kind of thing.
That's the holdup, unfortunately. But once I have that, I'm going to do a press release, and if you could help develop some kind of a PDF type thing that we could post on Facebook and start getting out there.
Yeah, I'd like to just get at least a notice on a list on Facebook.
Yes.
People are asking.
I did post something on Facebook that it was coming soon.
Okay.
And so we got a number of likes on it.
So are you talking about last year, this committee, or the DPW sent that really lovely flyer of all the events for the year?
Postcard.
It was, you post it on your refrigerator, and it's like, there it is.
Yeah, we don't have the money
that was
for that,
funded.
I think. It was grant funded, and
we're
not doing grants.
And we can do a half sheet that people could pick up at the transfer stations and put on the refrigerator. We won't have cardstock.
But we at least should
color,
have it digitally. On the DPW website, on the Facebook page,
and
to all the email.
And
I just want to make sure that the content is correct.
Keep pushing, because the squeaky wheel is getting the grease in my world right now.
All right.
So why don't you just keep knocking on my door?
Put TBA after the shredding then, or put
right.
Or
I will
possibly
just
the shredding
that
was
event,
part of the event.
Right. That event
that
includes other things. I won't mention shredding. We'll add it later. That's fine.
Yeah.
We'll just go. I think we should just go.
I think so too.
Right. Okay, the SOS project to event.
That was mine.
No, I said I would take that.
Yeah, John.
Oh,
the
potting?
Yeah, because I'm there anyway. And I talked
to
Jim
Levy.
You're
fabulous.
Well,
that's right.
I'm there anyway. So I told Jim Levy I'm going to do this part of it.
Uh huh.
So I don't have anything to report, but I'll talk about that today.
Great. Okay, then let's move on to and just spend a couple of minutes on the role in the EPS band project. Or actually, we should probably preclude that until we come up with mission and objectives.
It would be helpful. It occurred to me too. We haven't been asked to get involved, so.
Well, we haven't been asked, but it's important to a lot
here.
Of people on the committee, and there's validity in that.
Yep. I just didn't want to. I don't want to feel like I'm pushing it on you guys because of my experience in Amherst. I'm trying to stand back and let you.
As I remember, I was the one that put it on the agenda. So.
Okay.
Is there any new business?
I have a question. Can we make a subcommittee for promotional materials? I want you to help me make a logo for our committee and sort of a template for these events that we do over and over again, so that it's easy to put out promotional stuff.
Yes.
Anybody, you will do that with?
Sure.
And I will do that, Debbie. Anybody else?
Well, I'm happy to comment on.
Okay. Yeah. Well. Yeah. Sure.
Yeah, the potential logo.
Okay. So we'll find time to meet.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, great.
Okay. Any other new business?
I was gonna talk about My Eco and plastic bag ban. So My Eco, they realized that the legal maneuver's not gonna work so well or take too long. So they've come up with a new strategy. So they're gonna roll out a new app on Earth Day this year, which they sent a presentation. It will remind, so people with a smartphone, they can download the app. It will remind them, they can load, these are the stores where I shop. As soon as, I'm assuming GPS knows when they're driving into the store, it will alert them, don't forget your bag. So they bring the bag in the store.
So the app reminds you about your useful bag.
Isn't that brilliant?
That's great.
I mean, brilliant.
Supposedly, that's what they're saying. So they for them, it's a whole chicken and egg they can't get the retailers on board until the retailers know X number of shoppers are going to be willing to do this.
Mm-hmm.
They can't get the shoppers on board until the retailers are willing to participate. So they've gotten funds for a couple of schools due to a pilot project where the school folks will participate just to collect data, so then the retailers can see, oh, all these people are willing to, you know, do the reusable bags and participate in this program. So I've suggested we do a presentation to Northampton City Councilors. Either Kristen or Tom would come to Northampton, you know, get on the agenda. We'd have 8 minutes, they would go through their presentation. We can, you know, potentially have a reporter cover it, so we'd get publicity, you know, get it out to the public through NCTV. And I proposed, you know, they're saying, oh, maybe a competition or get groups to who want to participate to see how many members they can get on board and have a competition. But I was wondering, should we have a ward competition? Like how many people from each ward, you know, how many bags?
Well, what's the objective of presenting to the city? What do you want from the city council?
Well, it's really a way to get the word out, you know, and it's to get...
So you don't want anything from the city council, you just want to promote...
Well, I mean, I've called the city councilors, and they said to me, well, we're all for a plastic bag ban, but the residents aren't calling us, you know, every day saying, we want a plastic bag ban, so that it's not on their priority list. And so my thought is, okay, so we need to reach out to residents, we need to, you know, educate people, let people know. You have a competition that gets a lot of people excited. You know, it's like, oh yeah, the world's against each other. Let's see who can win. Who's gonna, you know, avoid using the most plastic bags when they shop?
Do you know about the plastic bag ball that we made in Northampton birthday a couple of years ago?
No.
That was like 800 pounds or something like that. Mm-hmm. So the public schools all collected plastic bags for months to make this giant ball that was assembled. I don't even know where it was. Was it Jackson Street or JFK? And then it was horrible. It was pouring rain that Earth Day, and they they couldn't roll it. I can't remember how they were transporting on somebody's wagon, and so they had this parade, and there was a brass band that was playing as they paraded this giant plastic ball through town. As far as I know, we still have it.
800 pounds.
Something like that. Yeah, it was enormous.
I can't imagine.
Yeah, but plastic bags are heavier than you think.
Well, and the other purpose of the city councilors...
When they're all pressed together.
So educating the city councilors, I mean, I know my city councilor has a list of residents that where he can email out, so that's sort of putting the city councilors on the spot. Okay, you can contact your residents, get them on board, get them participating, or have a competition. You know, so you're sort of using them as a resource, and potentially get an ad in the paper about it. So that was just... And you know, and Mike was willing to go that route if...
Charlotte Costin is the woman who organized the giant plastic ball. I don't think it was a competition. I think each of the elementary schools just collected their own plastic bags that were then made into a giant ball. So she'd be a good person to speak to about the history of that and who got involved, and because that would possibly just give you a link into the public school system for promoting your competition.
Yeah, if it's still around. I know that there was some concern about how it was going to get recycled. That's my memory. I remember thinking it was such a brilliant PR thing. It was brilliant. Mm-hmm. And Karen had said that it was because of it being in a ball that it was, they didn't know how to recycle it.
Well, it won't fit into one of those bins at Stop & Shop.
but the power, I mean, if it's still around, just having it to promote something like this, you can have it travel, you could have it sit in City Hall for a day in the lobby, and you know what I mean? I mean, you could really use it to promote the whole concept of do we realize what we're doing by using these things for 5 seconds and throwing them away?
Yeah, they don't go away.
It wasn't as big as you would think.
Oh, no.
It was heavy, but it's not that
very
big.
Compact.
Yeah, it's really compact. It was less impressive volume-wise than I anticipated it would be. More impressive weight-wise.
Yeah. Because
I have a box and I stuff plastic bags in there. I mean, the number of plastic bags I can get in, where it really even feels like it's amazing.
For publicity, I mean, if we're talking about publicity and awareness building, there's a lot of cool things that you can do. My brother, who lives in Seattle,
when we were doing the foam thing, he had some really brilliant ideas. Mm. That was, what did he call them? Guerrilla marketing. And he said that in martial arts, they say you use the power of your component against them. Uh-huh. And so you think about he was talking about foam. What is foam's strength? It's cheap. So he said, and plastic bags are cheap. And so mm-hmm. he said, you get a crate of foam containers and put a message in each foam container and leave them everywhere. It's just for awareness building and stuff. You know, it's mm-hmm. kind of like it becomes a performance art or installation art kind of. Anyway, I thought you could do something similar for plastic bags, but you wouldn't want them to blow around. You'd have to tack them somewhere so they blew, but they didn't move, you know?
Make good wind catches.
Yeah.
Jessica, anything else?
The lending library. So both Barbara Black, Barbara's going to talk to Head Start and see if they're interested in a toy library. I started researching, I found there's a Berkshire Toy Lending Library, and I found there's a really old one in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and so I sent them both a list of questions to try to get more information about how they're run. The Northampton, the Parent Center volunteer and Barbara are willing to collect some people who are interested and get together and have a meeting about a potential lending library in Northampton.
Which reminds me, Peter, you may want to contact Barbara Black to see if she wants to. Okay, great.
And where is that plastic bowl?
It was at Leeds School, I think, but I don't know. Karen is probably the last. Or Charlotte would know, certainly. Charlotte Costin. I have her email address if you want to.
Mm-hmm. Oh, and actually something else. Is Charlotte the one that was collecting petition signatures for the plastic bag ban?
Probably.
So I had emailed her because I thought she might want to get involved, and I hadn't heard from her. And then all of a sudden, a parent from Jackson Street School emailed and said, "Oh, I heard through Charlotte that you're working on this." And so I sent her all the information, history of the plastic bag ban work. And she got back to me and said, "Oh, there's a concerned parent group at Jackson Street School. We want to pass a plastic bag ban and a styrofoam ban. So maybe we can all meet."
Do you know who Mary Clark is? She was one of the founders of this committee, and mm-hmm. she's the head of the PTO at mm-hmm. Jackson Street School, so I'm sure she's driving some of that. She's terrific. And she was the creator of the toy event.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
And ran it for several years. Do I have a motion to adjourn?
Mm-hmm.
Second?
Second.
Oh, before we adjourn, actually, the date of the next meeting?
Oh, yes.
All right.
Dave, the next meeting, well, it depends.
Hopefully
on
it doesn't conflict with Passover.
When is Passover?
I don't know.
Spring.
Well, if it was the first Thursday, since this is the first Thursday in March, it would be the 3rd, which would be good.
Should we go for the second Thursday, the 10th?
Well, we talked about needing to review
That's the plan
for the reuse center so that we can get it to.
Because you also don't want it to conflict with public school vacation. Mm-hmm.
Right.
Which would be that week.
Easter is the
20th.
14th to 18th.
Passover is the week of the 14th.
Yeah. I would guess that's probably vacation as well.
Right. Yeah. And Good Friday is that Friday.
I think the 3rd would be a good, because then we can.
It's fine with me if it's fine with Diana. Jessica, she's going to be leaving that meeting. This is my last meeting.
Is Jessica?
Oh, April what?
April 3rd.
So the rotation comes around again.
I think so. Okay,
we'll
tentatively say April 3rd. And thank you, David, for your service wearing a
thank
chair
you.
Hat.
Look forward to doing it again.
What's the next role model as you retire from this?
Taking on the subcommittee of the mission and the objectives,
right.
I think.
All right.
So, John, you're going to be the
Jessica's job.
Okay.
So we are adjourned?
We are adjourned.